Welcome to a new test and teardown video. I already released a video about the Hameg plugin modules and also this HM8037, but this one is a new one that just arrived and it actually has a problem that is quite general, so that is why I would like to show you how I repair this mechanical problem, because I think this information is very useful for all sorts of other restoring projects. So let's get to it. Something to do with those long, sticky potentiometer shafts. It looks like stuff is broken from the outside, but let's open and have a look. And here is the problem. For some reason, they really think this is a good idea with these couplers. But of course, if this potentiometer is not at a perfect center align with the hole and the shaft and all that kind of stuff, yes, of course, this potentiometer will go move a little. Oh, this is actually quite stiff. So that is why you use these couplers. It also isolates electrically, so that may be what they aim for here. We can see, there is a ground, is the metal ground is probably the pin, but you don't want, when you touch this, you don't want all sorts of hum to get into the system, so that is probably what they really want to have here. But they crack, see, they are completely cracked. They are made of nylon. And with those little set screws here, when you turn those too hard, you kind of crack the nylon exactly as we see here. So what are we going to do with that? I think we can 3D print something. And it's the same diameter, both of the potentiometers, I think so. That will be 4 millimeters. So I think this will be a very, very easy 3D printing challenge for me. Let's get to it. So when I'm looking at the design in the original little coupler part here, first of all, I can see what they're trying to do here. They're trying to make the material where the screw is and where the thread is as long as possible. So the screw here, this little set screw, got some more material, right? So all that is good. But why didn't they make this entire circle here the same amount of material? Because we know that we have at least this material as a safe distance to whatever it is we got down here, right? Otherwise, we couldn't have, you know, space for these. So they're actually trying to save material and make this part weaker and a less, you know, good product. For whatever reason, to save material here. That is stupid. So the first thing I did was to measure the safe distance. Where is it? The smallest, not up here, right? But down here, my safe distance, if I put this in here, and if I measure, look at that. I got that much distance. So what I'm doing is I measure the diameter here and remove a few millimeters. So now I'm down to 15. And then I'm still not going to touch this IC. And then I should be perfectly fine. Also, I steal this whole idea about having these two little pins and those two little pins here. But I want to make this much more 3D printer friendly. So I want to make V cuts so I can 3D print it. And yeah, that's basically it. Also, the length of this one here, this is also a problem, see? Why not make this longer so I touch more of the shaft, both ends? That will also make this part much better. And yeah, I want to 3D print it standing upside. So again, that talks for making these V-shaped. So I think that should be able to do that without any support or anything like that. And yeah, I go for PETG. That is a real strong material for something like this. I think they chosen nylon, but nylon also is a little bit brittle. It's stronger but more brittle for some funny reason, but so that's why I want to go for something that's a little bit soft. So going from idea to 3D design takes only a few minutes when you are as crazy as I am about 3D printed parts and designs and stuff like that. See, I think this should do it. So now I am up where I got all my slicers. I don't know if you can see this, the red indication here. I mean, I am of course pushing it a little bit with the overhang, but anyway, let's see how this goes. Now I'll start the 3D printer. It will take about a half an hour to make a tiny little part like this. Well, that's because I'm running it quite slow in PETG, because that is a very durable material for mechanical components like this. So we'll have to see.
So here is the fantastic part I 3D printed. I of course up the length of the set screws to 6 millimeters instead of 4. So I got some more material. And of course the diameter fits pretty good. If I stick it in here on the potentiometer shaft, it's just barely touching. No, it is not. There is a whole millimeter of safe distance, and that is exactly what I wanted. So here it is screwed perfectly in, and we see all the safe distances is nice, and the start and the stop position of the knob is also perfectly fine and aligned, and it runs smooth.
So now both of the potentiometers have been fixed and now they're super duper good. There is another little thing. I think this is one of the reasons why they broke to begin with. The lubrication there is on the potentiometer shafts inside the potentiometer, that kind of oil turns itself into chewing gum over some years. So if you give this a tiny little drop of contact 61 or something like that, then it goes in there, and then see, I don't know if you can see that, but yeah, I can just grab this real easy, and now they move super super smooth. Well, I don't really plan to make a long video about this particular unit here, because I already released a video about this low distortion generator. So if that is what you came for, please go to my video section and search for this one, and there will be a detailed video about its features and functions. But thank you very much for watching. I hope you can see that 3D print and 3D design is definitely a good way to fix stuff right here, right now. We don't need to wait for spare parts.